Happy Valentine's from me, Jeffie. I hope everyone's fine out there, and I hope you enjoy all my videos that I posted. I'm still working on trying different techniques for videos, so this time I'm shooting in daylight because my past few video tutorials were like shot at night, and the light was like, I had two fluorescent lights in front, so it's pretty much bright. And yeah, I don't know, I'm trying this natural light thingy and see how it goes, maybe, I don't know, yeah. So anyways, Valentine's is around the corner, and I decided I'm gonna do like a sweet, kind of like an angelic kind of look. Yeah, something towards the lines of an angel and Cupid, something mythical, so I hope you guys like it, so let's start! Starting with a clean face, I have applied M.a.c. Strobe Cream to help give my skin radiance and glow. Since this is an angelic look, you would want to apply a liberal amount to give your makeup that diffused lighting effect. Apply evenly until your skin has fully absorbed the product, followed by prepping your lips with lip balm or Beige to help retain moisture. Then, choose a foundation that is 2 or 3 times lighter than your original skin tone to help brighten skin. For this tutorial, I've applied Revlon's Photoready in Golden Beige to achieve this look. Using a foundation brush, I've applied it from the center of my face downwards, beginning from under the eyes and the bridge of my nose to the rest of my face. If you don't have concealer, camouflage flaws by applying another layer of foundation on areas where you need it. To help smooth out lines, use a sponge to blend out. Don't forget the neck since the foundation tone is lighter. Next, set the powder. You can use any type of finishes you prefer, but since I wanted to create that angelic glow, I used Kate's loose powder, which has tiny gold shimmer that gives out that diffused glowing effect on my skin. Apply with a loose powder brush for that natural finish. Applying powder will also help makeup from creasing. And after removing all excess powder, press down with a makeup puff to help makeup stay even longer. Now that you have your base done, it's time to create the Cupid's eye. You can choose to do your eyebrows before or after eyeshadow, but I personally prefer to do mine first since my eyebrows are untrimmed at the moment. So what I'm doing is simply arranging my natural brows and then defining them so that they shape my eyes. Start off with a mascara comb brush so that the hairs are in place. Then using a pencil liner, fill in your brows for better definition. Tilt your head backwards to ensure that both brows are evenly lined. Brown is always a favorite in my book since they provide a softer look. And since I'm creating this Cupid look, what better way to change my face than to lighten my eyebrows? But instead of bleaching them, I use the brow mascara by heavy rotation, which is a Japanese brand and sure does the trick. Here's what it looks like with one side done. Apply in an upward motion until you have fully covered each hair on your eyebrow. For darker eyebrows like mine, you need several coats of mascara to achieve the desired lightened effect. Now that the brow is done, it's time for the fun part. Start off your eye makeup by applying eye base to help colors stay longer. Then select a light metallic champagne color and apply across your eyelids. You can also use any highlighter color for this, just as long as it shimmers. Then choose a dark brown color and apply it to the crease of the eye. For this look, I used a velvet eyeshadow from M.a.c. in Mulch and apply it starting from the outer corner of the eye inwards. Remember not to overdo it since we are creating a softer look. Followed by applying the same light eyeshadow to the brow bone to accentuate the eyebrows. Blend in the crease once again to soften the contrast and complete the shadows, and your eyes are done. To finish the eyes, start by curling your lashes and coating them with black mascara. Use a less voluminous formula for a more natural finish. However, if you love volume, you can always layer on later. Always remember to apply in a zigzag motion to get more product on your lashes. Finish by applying white eyeliner on the lower waterline for that wide eye effect. For an added boost, apply highlighter to the inner corner of the eye and below the lower waterline for that shimmery finish. Don't forget to check your makeup by hooding your eyes if you have lighting coming from above your face and adjust accordingly. Since we are not applying any liner or color below the eyes, apply one last coat of mascara to your bottom lashes to balance out the entire look. Next, my favorite part, sculpting. As you know, due to my recent over-excessive eating, my face has expanded. So lucky for me, I have shading to help give an illusion of a slimmer me. Using an angle sculpting brush, I've applied MAC's Mirror Eye Skin Finish in Deep Dark to help shape my face. You can apply it under your jaw to camouflage your double chin, or to the sides of your face for a more defined cheekbone. But my personal favorite is to apply it on the sides of the nose bridge to help make my nose appear sharper. Blend with your fingers for a natural finish. To finish off the face, I've applied another mineralized skin finish from MAC called Porcelain Pink to help give my skin that glowing finish in photos. Since I've decided not to use a blush, this is a perfect finishing product that can be applied on the cheeks and across the face without looking too cakey. I finished the rest of my look by applying a nude lip color on my lips. This one is from Revlon and it's called Soft Nude. I've also applied a thin layer of silver shimmer on my lip for the high shine effect as you can see up close. As you know, disco is making a big comeback this year, so before I get changed into character, I have one final touch to give this look a little edge. Glitter. Line your lower eye with a hint of silver glitter for the angelic Cupid light effect, and you're set to go. This will look great when the spotlight hits you.
Hey, it's me, and yeah, this time I'm gonna be doing a much different look from last time, and as you can see, it's an angelic-inspired makeup for Valentine, so I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial. It's pretty simple, it's easy to do, and yeah, if you like this look, continue watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Bye!